Hey, how's it going? Can y'all hear me?
Oh, okay.
Hey, how's it going, everyone? My name's Austin. I'm with Rising Word Entertainment. We put on all the free events here at the Riots, so check us out on social media. I'm really excited for what we got for you guys tonight. Without further introduction, I'll be in welcoming Lil B the Bass God.
What's up, family? How's everybody doing tonight? Let me switch up mics, man. I got a lot of choices up here. One sec.
Very good tonight, feeling very good. You know, it's a blessing to be here with you guys, you know what I'm saying, and spreading this love and being here with these beautiful people. All you guys, I appreciate you for taking the time out, you know, to come talk to me and to hear me speak and, you know, be a part of this history tonight, you know. And, you know, I definitely took a lot of time out, you know, to figure out what I was going to come and talk about today and bring awareness to it. You know, just make sure I come here to settle your minds, because number one thing is, you know, we have come very far, and we should all be appreciative and pat yourselves on the back. And thank you to the University of Florida and the beautiful staff, you know what I'm saying, and the school. You guys have a wonderful university. And, you know, this is testament to how far we are coming, you know, just as people, as a community. You know, this is just amazing. So, you know, thank you for all the support, supporting me and such like that. So, you know, I definitely made a quote for you guys that is personal for UF that I thought about and I wanted to bring to you. And it says this: we deserve the right to live. We deserve the right to love. And thank you, thank you. You know, so how my style is, you know, in my vibe, yeah, you know, I like that. But you know how my style is, and kind of my personality is, I'm very, Yes. thank you. You know, I like to segue a lot. There's a lot of things on my mind, you know, like I'm always switching up, you know, subjects, because it's a lot of things that I do want to speak about. And as you see, I do have a lot of notes for you guys that I personally wanted to talk about. Thank you. Something I care about. So, you know, hopefully we'll be able to get through as much as possible in a timely fashion. And, you know, just give everything to you guys that I was thinking about and I was writing about. But I think the first thing, you know, coming to my mind was talking about traditions and transitions. And, you know, from all the knowledge that we are acquiring, you know, there's a lot of stuff that has been going on. And it's a beautiful, you know, transition that we're actually in right now. Like, for us to be able to be doing this, for you guys to be supporting an unsigned, you know, independent artist like myself, who really is doing this 100% by myself, you know, no backing, no corporate backing, really just me by myself. So, you know, it's just a really special time on earth, and, you know, just a really beautiful time to be alive, you know, not just because of me, not just because of us, but just because this is just a cool time to be alive right now. You know, it's just, you know what I mean? We're not gonna lie, man. It's a great time.
Be totally honest.
So, you know, I definitely think y'all need to really just make sure we continue to pat ourselves on the back about that and realize how special this time is, and, you know, how special your time is. as human beings and whatever you feel that you are, you know what I'm saying? Definitely your time is extremely special, and this is just a great time on earth. So, you know, I'm definitely extremely humble about that. And, you know, it's just super positive, you know, it's super positive. So with that, we're coming to about comparing yourself, you know what I'm saying, and making sure you never try to compare yourself to someone's outside, you know. So never compare your personal excellence to your inside and judge yourself for someone's exterior. You get what I'm saying? Like, and what I mean by that is, like, you know, because we all have our exterior shells, our personalities, you know what I'm saying, and like our you know, how we represent ourselves, but then we have our inside feelings. And you know, we all are a victim of judgment, prejudice, and stuff like that. And I know it's super hard to always get over that and to switch up and to, you know, change your thoughts, which you were, you know, where these thoughts were just, you know, continuously fed to us, and, you know, we've seen it over and over. So it's crazy to sometimes have to retrain yourself to think, even though you guys are doing this, and that's why I respect it, because you guys are learning daily, pushing your minds and pushing yourselves to the maximum. And, you know, I really respect that a lot. It's not easy to do what you guys are doing. So please always take a deep breath, you know what I'm saying, and congratulate yourself. Treat yourself by, you know, drinking water, taking care of yourself. You know what I'm saying? You know, yeah, definitely treat yourself, you know what I'm saying? Like, whatever makes you feel good, don't live for somebody else. You know, if you think picking flowers and sitting at the tree is what makes you happy, you know what I'm saying? Like, do that, you know what I'm saying? And don't feel bad about that, you know what I'm saying? Because I definitely have my things that make me happy, you know what I'm saying? And I like taking long walks, you know what I'm saying? I love taking long walks. Yes. And so, you know, I don't compromise. And, you know, really what it is, I love actually taking long walks by myself. So, you know, that's a big thing. And a lot of people are like, why do you do that? You know, why do you want to do that? And, oh, to add that, so I actually take long walks by myself at nighttime. So, yeah, you know, people really think I'm crazy. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, it's just a, you know, a big, you know, you just live how you live, man. And, you know, with living, we're always figuring out, you know, what is our purpose of living? You know, why are we here? You know, trying to figure out what, you know, we are here for on this life, on this earth. You know what I'm saying? And definitely, for me, I feel like, first thing, us realizing the common that we have, just all being in here together, which is a beautiful thing. We're all coming in here, you know, to hear me speak, and as well as to hear something new, which is automatically, so everybody in here could automatically be like, okay, we have something in common, because obviously, if you came here tonight, you're obviously a forward thinker, or you're cool, or you're open-minded, or, you know what I'm saying? Or something. You know what I mean? Something is cool about you and different. So that's our... I love you too. Hey, how's my mic sound? My mic sound cool? I hear a little cracking. Is that alright? You let me know. Or should I change up? Because I got options. Hey, man. Nah, but, you know, going back to just figuring out our purpose and such like that, and, you know, sometimes we're filled with so many different ways of living and ways that we need to live our life and being told of how we need to live our life. And, you know, with me choosing to become an artist and an entertainer, as well as putting love through music, because the core foundation of why I even make music is because I know that music has a power to connect and connect people, to heal, to help, to invoke emotions. It's an art form to me. And it's something that you study. I'm inspired by life. I'm inspired by people. I really take everything just and I soak it in, you know, from this is music to me, and I can get inspired by that, from that little sound that, you know what I'm saying? Like I everything I'm taking bits and pieces from, you know, and it's like, and it's clinging to me like I'm a magnet, you know what I'm saying? And this is like clinging on my body, and I'm soaking it. I love it. But you know, I'm just soaking things in, man. And or one man, you know what I'm saying? And you know, yeah, we're thinking. We're making sure we do not leave anybody out. You know what I'm saying? That's the number one thing. No one deserves to be feel left out. You know, we want to always include and make sure everybody understands that they are welcome, no matter what type of words. You know, because we stop by words, you know, words stop us, you know, or groups stop us. And we got to make sure to know that, hey, you are welcome in my group. A group is for everybody to be in, you know, and, you know, regardless of whatever, if you feel like you want to be in my group, I think you could damn well be in there. Excuse me for cursing. But I appreciate it. But, you know, like I said, going back to why I really make music is just because I understand the power of, you know, words and putting words together and getting into a zone where things really just become fluid and very natural to you because you've been practicing it for a while, you know, either practicing positivity or practicing music and stuff like that. So my goal for music, I didn't come into music to make money, and that could either be a good or a bad thing, you know what I'm saying? But good or bad thing to who perceives it, you know what I'm saying? But I feel like for me and my core value, I always feel extremely special because I'm like, I never came into music for the money. I never came into music, you know, for a financial payout or say, hey, I want to be, you know, some millionaire, multi-billionaire rapper, a millionaire rapper doing whatever the millionaires and billionaires do. I was just like, I want to make music because it makes me smile, it makes me feel good. I know it makes other people feel good. People like when I rap, and it makes me feel good that people acknowledge me and give me praise in for something that I love to do. And I think that's important that we always remember that, you know, people yearn for praise and people yearn to be accepted. You know, I think we all deserve to be accepted and to make sure that no one is being rejected for how they want to live. As much as we feel that this is right or this is wrong, you know, we need to make sure that, you know, we all treat each other equally and make sure, you know, and that's a broad thing to say, treat each other equally, because everybody's life is a special case, and I think we deserve to listen to it, and you know, just figure out the best way to interpret that message. But you know, making sure also when, as I come into music and saying like that, you know, not being in it for the money and stuff like that, I think a big thing is also to make sure when you do acquire wealth and you know, money and things from your hard work, and for you loving what you do, hopefully. And I think everybody should, if they're not, work to transition and have that goal in the back burner of making sure you find that thing that you love to do, regardless of what it is, you know, regardless of pay or not or whatever it is, you know, you find that thing that you love to do. But make sure you also don't hoard the wealth, or, you know, make sure, you know, you don't hurt these other people to make sure that you get paid. That's one thing I have a lot of pride in with myself, and thank you. I have a lot of pride in is not, you know, I've never stepped on anybody, and you know, that's like a figure of speech or whatever, but I feel like I've never, you know what I'm saying? Really, I haven't stepped on anybody because I'm not violent, you know what I'm saying? Other than that, you know what I'm saying? But, you know,
just I feel good just with my ethics of business and how I feel about my business and how I feel about Lil D is that you know, I just feel really good. Like, hey, I've earned my money in a very honest and you know, just a good way to me, what I think, and you know, just with integrity in my business, not compromising myself, which is a huge thing. You know, I go to sleep at night, I feel good. I don't feel like I'm not laughing and saying, ha, 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 you know. I actually, you know what I'm saying? Like, ha, ha, I just made a deal and I got over it. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? Like, I actually feel really good because, like, I know that my core foundation is love. I'm spreading love. And people tell me this is a testament to love. And, you know, just a lot of other things, you know. So for me, it always feels good to just get the truth, you know what I'm saying, and know why you are in the, you know, the line of work that you're doing or your future goals, and, you know, continue to rock with those. Also, it's crazy. Sometimes... How many people are afraid of hard work? Physical. I know this is hard work, which I do a physical hard work. I am sometimes. I ain't gonna lie. You know what I'm saying? Like, look, man. I just did the hot pots thing where, you know, you cook and I feel like I was doing a big thing. I'm like, man, I'm cooking. You know, like, you know what I'm saying? I'm like, man, you know, I feel like a grown man, you know, I'm cooking my own stuff. Yes, hey, but you know, it's crazy though, I'm just super embarrassed about, you know, when I do talk about eating and just about that. Because I actually wanted to say where I was going to eat at, but I'm just so sensitive because I know I'm kind of ashamed of meat. You know what I'm saying? And eating meat, it's just not like a... I know, I'm ashamed of it. And I'm sensitive to the people that do not eat it, as well as it's just... You know, I always am just like, man, you know, sometimes you just wish you... Like, I wish I was just born with a set of different tools, a different, you know, a different mindset. You know what I'm saying? It's like, you know what I mean? It's like, oh man, I've just been so used to this. You know what I'm saying? It's like, God, but you know, we're growing out of it, and me accepting other mindsets, you know, opening up, learning about different people has helped me so much, and to be more humble about things and making sure when I do speak about things, I'm not only thinking about myself, but thinking about everybody else that might be listening and that care about me, or that just care about, you know, people in general. And yeah, I guess, like, you know, people being afraid of toil and working hard and that physical hard work, you know, sometimes it gets in the mix of, you know, your regular work, you know. And I definitely think I'm a victim of that sometimes, where, you know, you don't want to, you want to be able to do both, you know what I'm saying? It's cool to be physical, it's cool to, you know, get your hands dirty and do, you know what I mean by that is, you know, grow your own, you know, vegetables, you know what I'm saying? Or like, you know what I mean? And I know, you know, you guys are working extremely hard, you know, very lucky to be at UF, you know what I'm saying? You guys are a very special class and a very, you know, small percentage of people that ever will be able to get in here, you know what I'm saying? So definitely, I understand that you guys, out of anybody, know what hard work means. But yeah, like, I'm definitely a big about just, you know, using your mind, as well as, once again, I need to be... you know, listen to what I'm saying. And that's what I've been working on more is, you know, personal hard work because it feels good. You know, like I climbed up a ladder to work on a property. You know what I'm saying? Like I almost hurt myself. But I was like, usually I'm like, hey, you know, I'm going to just pay somebody. You know what I'm saying? And they'll do their job. But is that the healthy way to think? You know what I'm saying? Like, think about it like that. I'm going to pay somebody to do their job. Is that healthy? You know what I'm saying? And as long as I'm thinking about it in a, you know, that I'm actually trying to support that person, you get what I'm saying? And not just like, hey, this person's this, and I'm going to pay them and let them get away and let them fall and do whatever they're going to do. Hopefully they're insured. You know what I'm saying? And I'm covered. You know what I mean? But you know what I'm saying? Like, I paid you. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, we just want to make sure we're thinking of it in a healthy way. Like, I'm actually trying to support, you know, a local business, you know, people in my community. You know what I'm saying? Support the local businesses and businesses in general, thank you. And businesses in general, you know, I think we should support local as well as everybody. I think anybody that is trying to do something, we should at least listen and figure out what we can take from that in a positive way of learning and support them. You know, we all deserve to be supported in here. I feel like I'm being supported right now, and it feels amazing. And thank you. You know, and it comes down to, you know, mutual aid and caring for each other. You know what I'm saying? And supporting each other. It feels so good. And I will never be able to communicate that enough. And I'll always be able to, you know, continue to speak on that and push that. You know, like, we need to support each other, you know, care about each other. You know, we are together. And, you know, and it sounds funny and cheesy sometimes, you know what I'm saying? It really doesn't. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm really saying, I think it actually sounds pretty cool. It just has to be, you have to be able to internalize it. You know what I'm saying? Like, it has to be internalized, and you have to continuously hear this, like, okay, we got to work together. I got to, you know, support my, whoever, I don't know this person, but I want to learn about them. You know, I need to decipher the message. And that's something that I always really love to speak about, is deciphering the message. You catching the message. You know, you figuring out the person that you're talking to and trying not to judge them, but also just try to hear where they're coming from and why they're coming from that position. And, you know, I think that is a big, big thing. And with that, sometimes we are scared, you know. I think there's a lot of different levels of fear. Fear of being rejected. Fear of not being accepted. Whatever. Oh, okay. I'm trying to hear y'all, you know what I'm saying? If you got something to say, I'm listening. But, you know, yeah, fear of being rejected is, like, that's a crucial thing. You know what I'm saying? Like, think about it, like, if you try to do something and you know, like, everybody's going to make fun of you, or people are, you know, your core friends, or, you know, people that you respect, or, you know, a job, or, you know, something, like, people are going to be mean to you because of that, or treat you differently. You know, it definitely affects how you think about things. Just imagine a world like this where you had no boundaries on your goals. What would you really be doing right now? You know what I'm saying? Like, think about it, if you didn't judge yourself on anything, nobody else did, there was nothing that you couldn't do, what would you be doing? You get what I'm saying? And that's something for you to think about. Like, what would you be doing if you could do anything? Which we really can, but just think about that. You know what I'm saying? What would you be doing? And it just makes you think. It makes you think, like, what would I really be doing? And it's a lot of ideas. I got a lot of goals, and I feel like I'm definitely going towards them. And I'm, you know, making small steps towards the big goals that I want to complete. And there's nothing wrong with small steps. There's nothing wrong with setting goals in your mind and then putting them on paper. I think one thing about being a writer and an artist is I see how much power that a pen and a paper have. I love paper. I love how it looks. I love how it feels. You know what I'm saying? Thank you. I'm not happy with how paper's made, you know what I'm saying? I'm not, and I'm definitely trying to figure out ways to change that. And maybe, you know, maybe some of my smart friends in here, we could think of an idea together, you know what I'm saying? Because it's all about connecting the pieces. And you know, I think we could make something to supplement for instead of, you know, using this tree. You know what I'm saying? But we make some, you know what I mean? Hey, I'm telling you, man. I'm telling you. For real. No. What were you saying, sir? No deforestation. Hey, I'm just trying to make sure, man. You know what I'm saying? I'm learning just like y'all learning. And I'm not scared to. You know what I'm saying? I'm definitely listening, and I believe you guys. So please take that, you know, take that to your heart and know that I'm really listening to you guys. You know, I care about you. So, like, when you're telling me something, especially that, you know, you guys coming here and being a part of this and listening and giving your honest time out, I'm definitely going to make sure that I listen to you and really internalize what you are saying and anything that you need to talk to me about. So I think that's really an important thing, you know, trying to internalize what people say to you. And it's hard to give your energy to everybody. I'm definitely a living testament of being an energy giver. Thank you. And it's not easy. It's not easy. Giving up all your energy, you know, it's just like a never-ending thing. You know, sometimes you feel like it never stops. You're like, wow, it's like, so you don't understand, I follow 1.3 million people on Twitter, and I have I have 1.2 million followers. I follow them all by my hand, you know what I'm saying? Like, I grew all my social media platforms by myself from zero to, you know, 400,000 or, you know, 100-something thousand subscribers on my YouTube and, you know, these different things where it takes time, you know what I mean? That doesn't happen overnight, especially if you're not faking it like me, where I'm not using these robots or I'm not buying my followers, you know what I'm saying? Like, and I think that's you don't want to do that anyway. It looks good, but at the end of the day, you don't really know your true, you don't know what's going on with your business, you know what I'm saying? So you definitely want to know the truth, like when you got your followers and stuff like that, you know, just work slowly. Be yourself, you know, love everybody that is a part of your network, you know. So if you have 73 people that follow you, I think that's extremely important. That's 73 bodies. You know what I'm saying? That's 73 minds. That's 73 beautiful people, which will transfer into more people just with connection and supporting each other. You know, really. You know, so that, and with that, you know, and what I was saying with, you know, that of, you know, the followers and treating all your followers with love, and from with 70 to 100 or, you know, 1,000 to, you know, 500,000 to 1 million to multiple millions, you know, you just want to continue to keep your core values in your business and to treat all people with love. And what I think I have and what I pride myself on in my attitude is optimism and being optimistic. I think that's a very, very important thing with life, and it's very fun to be optimistic, actually. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's very fun, you know what I'm saying? Because I'm like, wow, you know what I'm saying? Like this happened for a reason, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's like, the tree fell on my leg. This happened for a reason, you know what I'm saying? And I'm finding why that happened, you know? And it might have happened because, I bumped the tree and it fell, or somebody was cutting the tree and it fell and I wasn't paying attention, or, you know, I got mad at my friend and I shouldn't have got mad and I left and I stormed the house and the tree fell on my leg. And that's not funny, because it might have happened to somebody, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, I'm always trying to find the message, You know what I mean? Like, find the message from the air and just find the message. Like, what does this mean? You know what I mean? And I'm telling you, it makes life so much better. Like, it's finding, you know, because life, what is life?
That is the biggest, I think, the biggest question ever. And whoever can answer that will be the top of the top. What is life?
Yes. And yes, my adopted tabby cat is doing very well, actually. She's very, very happy. So I'm always so prideful in that, you know, raising a friend who is quote unquote not human. And you know what I'm saying? Because they told me I'm black, but I don't know if I am, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? They told me I'm a man. Who knows? You know what I'm saying? I got breasts too. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, so I'm always kind of questioning things. You know what I'm saying? The facts, though, I respect it. You know, it's like, hey, four bolts in the tire, you know, the tire locks in. It's like, okay, that's a fact. All right. I get that. You know what I'm saying? But some of these other things that we could debate, man, it's like, you know, like, you're a man. It's like, what are you talking about, I'm a man? You know, I don't know. You know what I'm saying? You don't know either. You know what I mean? I'm just here. You feel me? I'm just here, and I'm living life, and I'm happy. And, actually, I can be whatever I want to be. You know what I'm saying? And me saying that I'm not saying it in a selfish way. I'm saying I for all of us, you know. I want you to take my energy and take my energy that I'm giving you guys and this love and know that anything that I'm speaking about up here is not in a selfish way. This is a sharing way. This is you being able to understand that you are me. Whether it's a woman, whether it's a child, whether it's a dog or a man or anything. You all are me. I am you. Now we have to, you know what I'm saying? We just have to accept it. We gotta accept it. You know what I mean? Just accept it. You know what I'm, but that's pretty weird. It can get weird, but you don't want to think too much. But we all are, you know what I'm saying? We all are one. And I think that's the main point of love that I'm trying to get. Like, you just always want to never forget, you know, never forget that. We all are one. We all are love. You know, manifest the love that I'm giving you. Become the love that I'm radiating, you know what I'm saying, to you. Whenever I say I, this is us, you know what I'm saying? Like, this is, take my experience because I'm no different than you guys, you know what I'm saying? We all have different stories and backgrounds, which I would love to hear about so I can understand you more and appreciate you more. But at the end of the day, one thing we all can have in common, which is sometimes harder for people, sometimes easier, but we can come together with love, and love can be our common factor, and or just being open. And I think coming here for this lecture and this speech and being a part of this is showing that everyone in here is open in some way. So I think that we all can find a way to love each other in here, even if it's in this room. Think about how many people are in this room and how powerful we are, just us, you know? And if we all banded together, or, you know, you at least remembered somebody from this room when you left, instead of just being like, hey, I'm not going to talk to this person, or, you know, walking out like, I look good today, I'm not going to say anything to anybody, you know what I'm saying? Like, or, you know, just looking at people and you know, you know how, like, the Terminator, like, looked at you and was like, and it, like, remembered you? You know what I'm saying? Like, try to do that. Like, look at this person, like, you know what I'm saying? And remember them, you know what I mean? Like, I think that's an important, like, try to, you know, I meet a lot of people, but I definitely try to, you know, feel like I'm the predator and, you know, reading. Once again, I'm not the predator in a negative way. I'm just the predator as in I'm reading and, you know, and figuring out who you are. You know what I mean? I'm scouting, you know what I mean? I'm definitely scouting, man. And, you know, another important thing that my uncle actually wanted me to tell you guys personally, he was like, I told him I was coming to the university for. He's like, oh my God, to tell them this. And I'm like, all right, uncle, you know, he's really loud and he's definitely, and it's crazy because I've working with different people, right? I used to actually, I'll tell you something about my personality, and it's cool with growing up and stuff like that. I learned some different stuff, but you know, my personality, I'm kind of like a softer guy, I guess, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm not just the most, like, physical, you know what I'm saying? Like, just, like, rough, you know what I mean? Like, I'm more just like a, kind of like, I like to, like, move out the way, you know what I mean? And give the right away and kind of evade, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm trying to evade things and not in a bad way, though, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm just trying to live my life, you know what I'm saying? Not get hurt, not fall, you know what I'm saying? Like, not scrape my leg. I don't like to do that, you know what I'm saying? I don't want to get stitches. I don't want to fall down steps, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm just trying to live my life. But, you know, it's crazy because, like, being with different personalities and stuff, like, I got, like, my uncle and then one of my friends who, they're more like, you know what I'm saying? And like my friend, he's just more like, I don't want to say confrontational. What's up, brother?
I love you.
I love you too, man. I love you too. What'd you say, love? I love you too. So, you know, it's like, yeah, it's like, so I'm with these personalities and, you know, for a while it was kind of rough on me a little bit. Like I would see myself get agitated a little faster because it was like a clash of personalities, you know, like they were very vocal and I used to take like a loud tone as like you were angry or, you know what I mean? Or like I would get defensive and it would make me uncomfortable, borderline want to cry, you know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, you know what I mean? So it's like, especially like with the family member or something, like, and like my uncle, you know, he's just like yelling, but that's how he is. He's like a bigger guy. He's always been bigger, so he has that bigger person's perspective, which not all big people have, you know what I'm saying? But he's just like really physical, you know what I'm saying? So it's like for me, I would always just see myself just like, man, like, why? You know, and then like my other friend, you know, he's just really like kind of an opposite of me, you know, and he's really smart though. He's really smart and he loves to think, but there's just another aspect of him where he's just extremely physical. And I think that might have been because he's grown up with a bunch of brothers and sisters. I don't know, maybe that's something, maybe not. You know, and from what he said, that's one of, you know, the things that kind of, you know, transformed him to who he is. So, with spending time with these people, it definitely helped me and got my skin a little bit stronger, you know, like, just being able to be around these individuals and learn why they are who they are and acting how they are, and kind of take some of their personality and put it into mind. You know, I got a little bit tougher, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm like, you know, I'm tougher, you know what I'm saying? You know, like, I definitely, you know what I'm saying? Like, I feel, you know, so you take the good, you know, you try to take the good from them. We don't have to agree on everything, you know. We don't have to agree on how they handle problems or how they handle situations. But I know that me being myself, they take the good from me too, and you know, as well as they listen to me,
And people should listen to you, and you, as you lead by example. You know, I lead by example. And then sometimes after a situation is done, my friend will come and say, 2 days later, 3 days later, like, man, you know what, you were right. And I'm like,
you know what I'm saying? So
it's like, it's crazy. It's like, dude, I'm lecturing at universities and you have the nerve to not listen to this. Like, bro, what's your problem? You know what I'm saying? What's it? But that's what, listen, that's my sickness. You know, I have to remember, like, you know, I'm like, okay, you know, calm down. You know what I'm saying? But sometimes you have to, like, bro, it's like, you over here. And, you know, I'm trying, you know, you give your all to your friends too, and like your family and stuff like that. And you're like, you guys just don't hear me. You know what I'm saying? It's like, obviously, you know, it's like, obviously I'm cool, or, you know, I gotta listen. You know what I'm saying? But main thing my uncle was trying to say is work while you wait. And getting back to what my uncle wanted to tell you guys is working while you wait. And what he means by that, and what I take from that, is definitely, you know, as we're on our journeys, as we have our end goal. How many people in here have an end goal? Where they want to see themselves, or, you know, where you want. And congratulations. How many people are still figuring out their goals in life and figuring out who they want to be? Thank you for your honesty. That's beautiful. And and how many people just have no goals in their living? They're like, I don't care. Obviously not here, because you're here, so obviously, you know what I'm saying, you care. So you don't even have to raise your hand, because I know you care, because you're here. This is students only. This is UF. You know what I'm saying? This is the Gator Nation, so you care. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, you know, it definitely... Short-term goals aren't bad, end goals aren't bad, and writing your goals down on paper, which I love, you know, getting back to the paper, putting those out on paper, that's when stuff gets real. You know, when I write my raps down, I'm not one of those guys that can think about the raps and formulate my rap in my head and then spit the lyrics, you know, like, I love the essence of writing on paper. I love the paper, I love the pen. If I was, what, in the 1600s, I'd be riding with a little feather, you know what I'm saying, on the, you know what I'm saying, dipping it in the ink and, you know what I'm saying, riding on the feather, that would have been me, you know what I mean, I would have been doing that, because I love the power with the paper and the pen. Writing your ideas is just so, it's crazy to me, learning, and what this, it's like, damn, like, you know, we're able to put these ideas. It's like, what is an idea, you know? And this is what's so beautiful about life, is we're just learning these different ways and exploring our mind and learning ways to, you know, put out our art and, you know, explain our emotions and explain our feelings. And it's crazy, because I draw, I do extremely rare art, you know, stuff from my... You know what I'm saying? Like, I just love expressing myself, you know what I'm saying? And being unique and just real to myself, you know, not trying to be anybody else. You know, like, it was crazy, because, like, I showed my friend or whatever, and he thinks he's just, you know, I'm like, these are my paintings, and these are my art, you know, like, this is my pictures, this is me drawing from my emotions, you know, because when I was drawing these photos, this was helping me relax and just putting my emotions out on paper and drawing and using these, whether it might be crayons or markers and just, yeah, crayons. yeah, exactly. You know, I'm bringing, look, man, whatever we got to do, man, it's the art, the medium, you know what I'm saying, and get it out. So, you know, I'm putting this stuff out on paper, and it's just so personal to me, and the art is beautiful to me. I love it. Like, I'm just like, man, I know where this comes from. I know why I did it, and I know that I will never be able to do it again, and it's amazing to me. And so my friend, he was just like, this scribble, and he was like, this is scribble. And he was like, I'm going to push you to make a real art. He was like, I want you to draw yourself. And I was like...
I was like, all right, man, you know what I'm saying? Fine, you know what I'm saying? Like, okay, I will, you know, like, I'm fine, whatever pleases you, you know what I'm saying? Since you're the boss, but, you know, it's just like, for me, I am happy with what I do, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm happy with the different artistic pieces that I make, whether it might be music, physical, just anything, you know. I'm happy with what I do because I feel special. The only reason why I feel special is because I get love, and people love me, and I know people love me. I love you too. I definitely do. This being here motivates me, I think, and it makes me love myself. I feel a lot of love vibes in here, you know, so hopefully it's transferring. You know, hopefully the energy is transferring and the love is, you know what I'm saying? And you can see, I got my sweater, you know, I took my sweater, you know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? Got some pants, y'all, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I mean? You know. Trying to look the part, man, you know what I'm saying? I should even put some glasses on, you know? Like, oh, this guy's gonna be. He knows what he's talking about, he got glasses on. Hey, man, you know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? You know, it's deeper than meets the eye, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's deeper than just somebody being like, oh, this is what it is, and this is the rules. He has glasses on, I believe him. You know what I'm saying? Hey, who looks at people sometimes like, you know, you got glasses on, I believe you. Who looks at people sometimes? At least you kept it honest. Oh, man. You know, I'm a victim of that. Sometimes just a victim, you know. And it might not be the glasses thing, but, you know, sometimes you're like, you know, this person is just saying stuff. You know, you got the nerve to say stuff. You know what I mean? I kind of believe it. You know what I'm saying? Like, you got some nerve, you know what I mean? But, hey, man, look, you start being like, 35 million, you like, Like, I'm listening. Cut the pie, 35 million, fraction. You like, Like, where's my phone? Let me check that out, man, you know what I'm saying? Where's my buddy at? Let me check that out. But, you know, man, it's a blessing, man. It's definitely a blessing. So, you know, where we come from is making sure that, once again, we don't compare ourselves to anybody in here. The thing is, we don't want to compare ourselves to anybody. Because when you compare yourself, what do? Either you're comparing yourself to make yourself feel better, or you're comparing yourself and then you're like, oh, damn, suck, you know, I suck, I'm not smart, you know, I'm weird, you know what I'm saying? I appreciate that. So I think the main thing is we're not trying to compare ourselves to anybody or anything, but what is cool is to compare yourself to your past self, you know what I'm saying? Like who you used to be, you know what I mean? And then you can... Because when I did that, I was like, man, like, you know, because I definitely maybe a couple months ago, maybe like 2 months, two to three months ago, because, you know, being unsigned and doing this extremely all by myself and being my own boss, I have the power to do things and I don't. So, you know, it was like kind of, you know, things were because, once again, it's not because I don't have demand or anything. You know, I'm actually the most demanded ever in my lifetime right now. But I just, like, I'm just, you know what I'm saying? Thank you. I'm just extremely rare, and I'm just like, I don't know if I want to do this. You know what I mean? But, you know, I was feeling a little, you know when things kind of slow down. Not really, but you just want to see progress, whatever it is. You know what I'm saying? Like, you want to you know, when you're sitting still all day, that'll drive anybody crazy. Anybody, it has to, you want to make tiny strides of progress. So, you know, for me, once I started comparing myself to my old self, I got really happy. I'm like, damn, I have accomplished some things, and I'm not, you know, like, I don't feel bad for feeling good. You know what I mean? And, you know, we shouldn't be upset for somebody that feels bad either, because, you know, we should try to help them as much as we can without withdrawing too much of our energy. And, you know, just send your positive blessings, because positivity does make an impact. And as much as you want to be mad, because there's times I'm like, I'm mad today. I want to be mad. Not I want to be mad, but, you know, it's like I made my mind up. I'm angry. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? And then somebody comes by, like, you know, like a loved one. Like maybe, you know, sometimes you're just really stubborn. I want to say my mom, or, you know, somebody, either your dad or somebody like that. And they're just extremely happy and just like, ah. You know, it's like, man, I want to be mad. Hey, man. Hey. Hey, man. Hey. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, you just want to be mad. And it's like, man, God, you know, like, this person's so happy. Like, I can't be mad, you know? And then you start, and then you feel like a jerk after. You're like, man, you know what? I need to loosen up. I just need to calm down. You know what I'm saying? So, definitely, it made me happy to start writing down. I got a little notepad right next to my bed. And, you know, I started, when I do remember, I would write down my dreams. And then I wrote down, like, what I've accomplished that I was proud of, you know what I'm saying, like, in my life. And once again, me saying, I'm, this is not about me. So don't take it as, like, this dude is just a knob, shut up. You know what I'm saying? Don't take it as that. You know, just take it. We're talking about all of us. Like, I'm talking about all of y'all, because everybody has things to be happy about that you've accomplished in your life. And I think you should write it down. And, you know, have it next to your bed, or have it somewhere where, you know, you can continuously write stuff. And you can remind yourself, because when I did that, I was like, man, I've done some pretty legendary stuff. You know what I'm saying? And I forget a lot of stuff, you know what I'm saying? So I'm like, it's like, what else have I done? You know what I mean? It's like, man, that's love, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, it's just like, man, continuously comparing yourself to your past, to yourself, making sure that you don't compare your inner to someone's outer, because that is just whatever it is. Whether, because I, you know, this is me dressing up, this is me being who, you know what I mean? But then we're all people, you know what I'm saying? We have an inner, and you want to make sure that you be yourself, compare yourself to yourself, you know, not the base guy, not Lil B. You know, not the scientist, you know what I'm saying, that you really admire, you know what I'm saying, or whoever, you know what I'm saying, the neurosurgeon, or, you know, whoever, but being yourself and being like, man, look how far I've got, look how hard I've worked, you know, like, look at that test that I passed, you know what I'm saying, that final that I did, that I worked hard on, you know what I'm saying, and, because, you know, it life is hard sometimes, you know what I'm saying? And you know what? Life is hard. But with support like this and a night like this, you kind of forget about that. You know what I mean? You kind of forget, like, this, like, when you go outside after this, like, there's a bunch of people that aren't part of this positive energy in this room. So when we go outside, you know, there might be somebody like, hey, you know what I'm saying? Like, what is your problem? You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm happy, you know what I'm saying? Like, we just came from a positive, you know what I'm saying? Like, we all about to kick it. I'm trying to hug. I'm trying to take some pictures with y'all. You know what I'm saying? Trying to ask a couple questions. You know, I had to ask a couple questions. And, you know, we're feeling good, man. We're positive. And then, like, you know, you go outside and someone tries to, you know, slap you or take something, you know what I mean, or insult you, you know what I'm saying? You're like, man, like, what is your problem? Like, it's like, man, you know what I'm saying? What is it? Life is crazy, you know what I'm saying? So we got to really just take advantage of this beautiful time in here, really hold on to this energy, really, once again, be that predator, that positive predator. You know what I mean by that. You're a positive predator, you know what I'm saying? You remember the people that are in this room. Like, you know, you scan everybody, like, I see you around campus, like, oh, I seen you from that, yeah, man, what, how you doing? Like, oh, you know, don't be scared to say what's up. Even if you guys say what's up differently, he might say hi like this, and you say hi like that, it's still hi, you know what I'm saying? Don't be scared, don't be like, oh, he thinks I'm weird, because I don't, you know, hey, hi, hey, you know what I'm saying? What's up? Hey, you know what I'm saying? It's all high. We're all trying to meet. You know what I'm saying? Don't be like, hey, what's wrong with, like, are you alright? Because he's like, oh, man. You know what I'm saying? It's like, it's, man, let these people be. You know what I'm saying? We're all embarrassed. You know what I'm saying? We're all embarrassed sometimes. You know, all the time. Whatever. But, you know, it's, don't rub it in, you know what I'm saying? Be, you know, it's, life is weird. Why are you trying to tell somebody something? You know what I'm saying? Like, go outside and something might fall on you. You know what I'm saying? So, like, quit trying to tell somebody something if it's not from love and from a positive place of caring. And once again, I'm sorry if I keep making jokes of things falling on people, because that's not funny, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's like a horrible, you know what I'm saying? Like, I was in a fire last year, and that's not funny, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, like, shit fell, you know what I mean? So, things fall. Whoever made this building is beautiful. This has not fallen on us. This is a beautiful building. You know what I'm saying? Definitely keep it humble. You know, just keeping things humble. And you know what I love to do? Going back to walking, I love to sweat. Sweating is great to me. I love sweating because I feel like I'm cleansing my body. You know what I'm saying? When I'm stressed out. You know, sometimes I see it like I'm stressed out and I'm like, damn, you know, like, I feel really weird, and I think about, like, how many days have I not worked out for? You know what I'm saying? Like, just sitting here, you know what I mean? I'm sitting here and I'm stressing. Let me go walk, you know what I mean? Like, let me go walk, you know what I'm saying? Let me go sweat. Now, obviously, and this is serious, everybody might not be able to walk, you know what I'm saying? So, there's different things for different people, you know, whatever that you like to do, and maybe you can't sweat. So I have to also, you know, take that in consideration, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, you know what I mean? Like, you have to do what you feel is cool and that you feel like, okay, I'm getting mental clarity. And I think that's my main point that I'm trying to get with this, is like, find something that's gonna give you mental clarity, that's gonna, you feel like you're being cleansed. You know, when I sweat, I feel like I'm being cleansed. I feel like salt's coming out of my, you know, body or whatever. You know what I mean? Like, I just feel like something, you know, just like my body's being, you know what I mean? Have you ever been active and, like, the sweat comes, you know, and it tastes salty? Have you had that? I mean, I don't know. Like, I mean, something's coming out of my body. You know what I'm saying? I think it's, you know what I'm saying? Like, I think I'm cleansing myself. I'm like, okay, I'm getting all this salty crap out, you know what I mean? And I'm blood flow, you know what I'm saying? The blood flow feels good and stuff like that, you know? I drank a lot of water before I came here. I'm happy about that. Yeah. And it feels good, you know, it feels good. It feels very natural to drink water. Like, it just feels like I'm supposed to be drinking that. You know what I'm saying? I look down the street, there was a little pigeon drinking water on the ground. I'm like, we're supposed to do that. You know, he's drinking water from a crack in the ground. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, this pigeon is doing it because he wants to. Also, what I've seen pigeons doing, I've seen them hanging out in groups. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's what we're supposed to be doing. If the pigeons are hanging out, we're supposed to be hanging out. You know what I'm saying? The pigeons are having fun, I'm telling you. They're under the bridge, they're flying to over the sea, you know what I'm saying? Whatever they're doing, you know, these pigeons are having a lot of fun, you know what I'm saying? That's all I'm about to say, man. I see them, they're hanging out, they're talking in the morning. How many of you guys hear the birds in the morning? They're talking, they're chatting, you know, we're just like, how these birds are, whatever they're doing. I'm like, man, these people are having a real conversation, man. Like, this is a real, you know what I'm saying? This is a real social community, you know what I'm saying? They're modern, you know what I mean? Contemporary birds, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, also, you know, just we definitely just want to make sure we're grateful for every day. And, you know, that's what I really just wanted to make sure I came here and I put this positivity on you guys and let you know, like, there's someone that's really living out here for the people. I live through you guys. I live through the love. You know.
Thank you,
Basedworld. Thank you. You know, a lot of people, and it's crazy for me because, you know, doing this by myself, I deal with a lot of different stresses, you know, so, like, I'll sometimes, like, you know, I've never done any official merch. So I see all this fake merch going on, this fake Lil B merch, and I'm like, wow, like, you know, like, I can't, you know, it's like, come on, man. You know what I mean? It's like, what are you, you know, but, and then, you know, people are like, you need to make a t-shirt. You need to sell a t-shirt. I'm like, okay. Like, okay, I get it. Like, let me do my art, though. I want to, you know, I'll sell t-shirts. You know what I'm saying? Like, I understand. Like, I get it. I'm in a special place where, like, people are influenced by me. And I definitely need to take advantage of that in a way, not in a bad way, in a negative, you know what I'm saying? But I guess for business or whatever. But then it's like, you know, I'm still living my own life at my own pace. I'm happy. I'm learning. I'm learning for myself. Slightly stubborn. Slightly learning. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, we're balancing it. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, it's crazy and sad. I actually got a bunch more I want to talk about, but time is coming close. So, I know, you know what I'm saying? There is a lot of love. I actually feel high off love right now, you know what I'm saying? Like, in a weird way. And this, man, we all can look at the same picture and interpret it differently, you know what I mean? And I think that's a big thing. We all can look at that same dot, and that dot might look different to you. It might look different to me, and it might mean something different to everybody. So, you know, life is what you perceive it, and it is what, you know, it is to you. Making sure these systems, these blocks, everybody, these communities, we get together. You know what I'm saying? We support each other. You know, we include each other. There's a lot of people that want to be where you are. You know, a lot of people want to be your friend. A lot of people respect you. A lot of people look up to you. A lot of people admire your style, admire your sense of thinking. They admire your mannerisms. They admire who you are as a person. They admire everything about you. And you should take heed to that. I think you're extremely cool. I think you're beautiful. I think you're everything. And you shouldn't forget that. And I know, you know, sometimes it feels uncomfortable with somebody's telling all this good about you, and you might be like, you know, deep down, you know, you might feel weird about it, I don't know, you know, but really take heed and take, you know, take heed to that, and I really, really love you, and understand that main thing, I love you, University of Florida, I appreciate you so much, I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you. I love you. And One thing I will be doing too, and we're gonna start, you know, start off some questions or whatnot. But one thing I want to do is, and please, when you ask me some questions, you know, definitely ask if you want. But you know, like, I mean, the NBA stuff, the TV stuff, the, you know, y'all can ask me that on Twitter. Ask me something that you really want to ask me. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, but it, like I said, if it's that. But I mean, that's like, you know, we got time right now, man, so make it special, you know what I'm saying? Make it something that you really care about. And also, I actually got a list. I got a list that I want to pass around, like, and this is me personally, like, I'm going to hit y'all up, you know what I'm saying? And if you want to write down your contact information, you know what I'm saying, and chop it up with me, put your email, what you doing. All right, everybody's leaving, huh? No, please mingle, please talk. But, you know, I'm definitely, I'm going to pass this around. So if y'all got a pen or whatever, please, you know, write your information down so I can keep in contact. I don't do that robot stuff. This is me personally, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm really going to hit you up personally. You know, I might copy and paste, but I'm talking to you personally and hitting back. You know what I'm saying? So I'm writing in the emails. Like, I'm writing in your email personally. You know that. Like, I'm not doing that bot stuff. Like, I don't like when people send me spam, so I won't do that to you guys. And, yeah, so please ask the questions. And shouts out to the staff that's made this possible. You know what I'm saying? And University of Florida, go Gators, baby. Any questions?
All right, let's give it up. Let's give it up one more time, for real. Okay, so what we're gonna do is, we're just gonna step up to the mic one at a time and get some questions to the bass guy. So let's go ahead and get started.
Big fan, bass guy.
Thank you, sir.
It's a pleasure to be like talking to you right now.
Thank you, man.
I kind of, for time's sake, I'll just ask like one simple question. Can you please cook for me?
Oh man, come on, man.
Just a little one.
Swag.
Thank you, bass guy.
Yes, sir. Yeah. I appreciate it.
Bass guy.
Yes. How you doing, brother?
Great. How are you?
Yes. Right. I'm good. Or sister. Or I'm not, you know what I'm saying? I'm not judging anybody. You know what I'm saying? I'm not disrespecting. I'm just saying I don't know.
You're open.
Yes. Well, I'm open. Thank you.
All right. So, my only question is, you mentioned you like art, markers, painting. So, I made you this custom Lil B hat. I'd like to give it to you.
Oh, thank you. Yes. Yes, I will accept that. Thank you. Person is, and you just got to make sure to try our best not to leave anybody behind. Everybody has a story. Everybody has power, you know? Everybody's extremely powerful, and it's either, you know, we support them and we promote it, or, you know, we kind of just let it go, you know? But I'm getting from talking to everybody has a lot to offer, you know what I'm saying? And really special, so that's what I got from. Yeah, thank you.
All right, bro, if you want to put your contact info, you know, you have to pass this around, man. This is mine, you know what I'm saying? Thank you, sir, thank you.
if y'all got like a pen or whatever, you know, put your contact info in, man. This is me directly. But yeah.
Hi, Ben Scott. How are you doing tonight?
Hey, sir. Thank you. Really good. Really good. Thank you.
I got two questions. One, would it be all right if with the staff and the officers if I came up and took a selfie with you?
Yeah.
And two, what is your current opinion on the public school education system?
Man. Thank you, man. First, yes, you can come take a selfie. Second, public school education system, I think definitely we should focus more on the arts. I think I love it, you know what I'm saying? Like, I actually went to Berkeley Arts Magnet, and I think that was an amazing school. I think it was elementary, and it lasted with me forever. I mean, I did my first poem on stage there, which transferred to me being comfortable on stage, getting rid of stage fright. I mean, we did numerous dance classes. You know, we slept overnight on the ship. You know what I'm saying? I mean, like, I'm in elementary school, so, I mean, all this just, and I was super scared. I mean, you had to cook on there. I was actually on the deckhand crew. You know what I'm saying? This was, like, elementary, so, I mean, you know, I think definitely we need to continue to focus on the arts and pay teachers way more. We need to make sure that, you know what I'm saying? Teachers, staff, anybody that's involved with education, education needs to be a super publicized and just a super cool job to do, and that we need to, you know, honor and continue to honor the education system because it is important, and as well as giving students individual time as much as possible, because the teachers that did help me out and show me that extra love when I was acting out in high school, because I used to do things to kind of like act out, like, especially when I would raise my hand and the light was on me, you know, and I was like, ooh, like everybody's looking. Like that's when I can like say something or make everybody laugh or be the class clown or be the bad kid or do whatever, you know, because I love that attention. And that's what transferred for me to going into music. But what really stuck out was the teachers that understood and really sat back with me and said, you know what, Brandon, like, you're super smart, like a history teacher of mine. English. She made me love English, you know what I'm saying? Because of how she took her time out to really care about me and, you know, support me individually, as well as another teacher of mine at Albany High named Mr. Perter, very supportive. And, yeah, I love teachers that love their job, even though it's extremely stressful, and I can only imagine what they go through, but, you know, please give the students that individual love that we need. Yeah. Yeah. What's up, man? How you doing, man?
Doing just fine.
Oh, man, okay. That's what's up, man.
Brandon, you said your name was?
Yeah, there you go.
Oh, you got to go on for the crowd, too.
You got to.
Thank you so much, Brandon. You're a great speaker.
Top, man.
Hey, yeah. Oh, yeah, you know, I'm going to have to get a selfie with the crowd, too, man. You know what I'm saying? You know, after we all done with the questions. But, yeah, what's up?
First of all, I want to say thank you, Babe Scott. I love you.
Love you, too. Thank you, man.
How do we all remain based or positive in the face of rampant negativity, hate, unfortunate circumstances, and in my personal case, depression?
Man, well, bless your heart. You know what I'm saying? Like, I definitely think, I think we all deal with depression. That's very normal and it's very human to feel different and to feel mood swings go up and down. And I think the best how we can deal with it is making sure we control what we are intaking, whether what we're watching, reading, who we're around. Who we're feeding information off of. And sometimes it's really hard because, you know, you might be addicted to the internet or specific websites or TV, you know, and it's just like, you feel kind of stuck, you know what I'm saying? Or whatever you're getting information off of. So you have to continue, I think, to go to the roots of what life is, and that's why I love to take walks. I love to be inspired by just the air and being outside and
and the water and the ocean, figuring out the simple things in life and making sure you're content with the simple things as well as staying focused on your major goals and short-term goals, but being content with the simple things in life and striving for more, for personal excellence.
Thank you, Basedworld.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Hey, Basedworld, I just want to thank you for coming out here. Really appreciate it. Really appreciate you following me on Twitter the other day.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You know, I got you.
I just wanted to ask you, what was it like working with the one and only Chance the Rapper?
Oh, man, shout out to Chance, man, on top. Yeah, man, and congrats to Chance the Rapper being on Kanye West's new album. Yeah, I think it was the first song on there. But, you know, it was an amazing experience. He's a real artist. Just seeing him, you know, freestyle, me and him freestyling, and seeing Chance really freestyle and sounded just amazing. He's just a real artist, and I definitely appreciate his lyricism and him as a rapper. I think he has some cool stuff to say, and you know, he's highly respected in the music game. A lot of people love him, and I'm definitely grateful to do something with him. And you know, we made history together, so it was great.
What's good, bass guy?
What's up, sir? What's up, sir?
What's going on?
I'm good, man. Yeah.
I just happen to be a pretty dope rapper myself.
Yes, sir. Yeah, I'll bet.
I just wanted to see if we could kick a little quick bass freestyle. Two lines, quick 10 seconds.
Yeah. All right, man. Let's go.
Everybody do a snap.
Yeah.
Snap. All right. Check this out.
All
right. They can't stop me, nobody could kill me. Haters get swag, chef cooking like I'm Lil B. Go ahead and I'ma drop it off. Okay, Lil B, go ahead, pick up with the bars.
Pick up with the bars, NUF, University of Florida, you know who's the best. Yeah. You know, you keep going, I feel like a gator, so you know that I'm rolling.
Hey, we're rolling, and we going. You know we got it, I'ma keep it flowing. And you know Lil B got that flavor. So go ahead, let me see you chomp like a gator.
Straight up, man.
Hey, what's up? Thank you, Base Guy.
Thank you, man. Thank you.
First of all, thank you in general. This is your freestyle, beautiful Chicago. You, Chance, Keith.
I appreciate it.
You talked about goals. What is your goal?
You know, I have a few of them, actually a lot of them. I think my major goal is to continue to spread love as much as I can and really help more people in more ways than just speaking about it. I really want to, you know, first enlighten like what we're doing, but I really want to be physical about my helping and just do everything that I can in my power to make people feel good. I think that's my biggest goal. And that's a broad goal, so I'm going to pinpoint more, you know, and be more specific. I mean, building a school, I think that's one thing I want to do. You know what I'm saying? So,
Thank you.
Hey, thank you, man. I appreciate it. Yes, thank you. Yes. I think my favorite rapper, who's probably motivated me the most in the world, probably Lil Wayne, Tupac. Yeah, probably Wayne. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, thank you. Thank you, man.
Hey, what's up, Lil B?
Hey.
Hey, my name is Kenny Tinoco, and one thing that really stuck out to me was when you were talking about your uncle, and he said, while you're waiting work, what are some times that when you felt like you had a pit stop in life where you just felt like what got you through?
Yeah, I think probably last year and this year is kind of like my pit stop in life where I'm like, damn, I'm not working on the same level that I was really used to music-wise. I think after I had my neighbor, I had an apartment and his house exploded, which burned me out of mind. And that really kind of changed my situation. It had things, me really feeling really different. Music is my source of happiness, you know what I'm saying? Being in the studio, making art, that's what I love. That's where I feel like my purpose is. And I feel like that's that, you know, so with me not doing that as much as I used to recently, I started feeling weird about my purpose in life and just questioning everything. So I think what has gotten me through is really the love, people still being here for me, you know, sticking with me throughout this whole time, even if I haven't been releasing as much music as I have been used to, you know, the last couple of years. People are still, you know, on me every day, you know, speaking to me every day, and acknowledging me and supporting me every day. So, you know, I definitely appreciate that more than everything. Thank you. Oh, yeah.
What's this, my brother? Okay.
It's called Bigger Than Hip Hop. And it's just really dope. It just talks about stuff that is our generation. Right. But we could do more than just that. And actually, Nicki Giovanni's right there.
Oh, yeah, man. You know, it's all good.
Yeah.
Appreciate you.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, you got any more questions?
Seriously, but from the sound bites, and once again, shout out to the NFL though. I missed the Super Bowl, but you know what I'm saying? I know everybody is watching. Yeah, from like, it's just, you know, it's crazy. I think personally, I heard different like attitudes and parties. You know, people was like, she supported a terrorist group and such like that, you know. And I think the Black Panthers, like, originated in Oakland or, like, where I'm from, or, you know what I'm saying, like, having their home base out there. I never got the vibe from anybody, like, that read the Black Panthers or me hearing about it on a grassroots level. Like, it was kind of an anti-America thing or, like, anti, you know what I'm saying, like, police. It never was, I never heard about it being like that. Like, it was more just protecting and uplifting the community, you know, like, because they did a lot of stuff that I heard about, whether it might be, like, feeding the community or, like, jobs and businesses and, like, protecting the police in the community, you know what I'm saying? Like, making sure that the people is cool. So, I mean, that's what I really, that's why, like, for me, I wasn't, like, you know, it for me, it was cool to see her repping that because, you know, a lot of times people, they don't rep, you know what I mean? Like, they might feel a certain way about repping it or be scared about it, you know? And stuff was weird back then, you know what I'm saying? So I think we just kind of got to keep it pushing, like, acknowledge the weirdness and also be so happy about the progression that we have made and acknowledge the progression a lot. And definitely acknowledge, like, the aspect of the weirdness from before and how the weirdness has poured on and still is relevant today. You know what I'm saying? So, like, a lot of the weirdness from before definitely has a big impact of today. So so we can't just forget about it, but we do have to acknowledge and be happy about our today, where how far we have come, you know what I'm saying? Thank you.
Thank you, Bass Guy.
Yes, thank you.
Yeah. I had a question for you. It's actually an ask. It's not for me, but it's for someone I really love.
Yes.
She's currently going through a lot right now. We were just at the Waka Flocka Flame concert. On
Shout out Waka.
Someone apparently elbowed her in the head, and she's now dealing with a concussion, so she's on bed rest and couldn't actually be here. And you are her favorite rapper. She was really, really upset that she was... she hadn't missed this.
Thank you so much.
She's also dealing with a lot of stuff at home, too, in her home life at school, and also her mother's battling breast cancer right now. So I wanted to know if, I know this isn't the Make-A-Wish Foundation or anything, so you can't, like, go to her apartment and actually surprise her or anything like that, but I was hoping maybe after all of these people were done with their questions, we can maybe do a video on the side of you just saying hi to her, maybe saying something inspirational, because she really is just upset she wasn't able.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. And it does send a good thought. You know, I definitely internalized and sent a good thought to her mother who is fighting breast cancer. That's very brave and, you know, a very personal issue. So I pray for her and making sure that she gets through it and gives us inspiration to fight, showing us that we can't fight through hard times, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah.
What's up, little boss?
Hey, man, what's up?
I just want to thank you. Not only your music, but the message you convey has gotten me through a lot of hard times, and it's still continuing to get me through a lot of hard times. But my question is, you wrote your book, Taken Over, at the age of 19.
Yeah.
Now, I know you've accomplished a lot more since 19. Is there going to be another book on the way?
Yep, it is. I already got the title. I've just been slowly but surely. You know, I got to quit procrastinating. I just got to do it, man. So maybe after this, I'm going to just get to start. You know what I'm saying?
Can you drop the title?
Can't drop the title. I want to, but I'll tell you like this, man. The title is one of a kind, never, like, it's been with me for years, so I know it's the right one. Like, I just can't wait to, it's gonna be really special, man. Like, thank you.
Hey, what's up, hey. Chanel here. Definitely want to thank you for coming out here to the U.S. Definitely appreciate everything you do and who you are. I have two questions for you. First one, my friend Derek wants to know why you've gone back on Twitter since 2013.
Oh, well, that's not right. I probably just haven't seen him, you know what I'm saying? Or if I have seen him, I just didn't. Well, I got to follow you now. Don't beat me up now, man. You know what I'm saying? Yes, sir. I will follow you. I will.
But my next question is, with all your, you know, beautiful bass music and mixtapes and whatnot,
thank you.
What do you plan on releasing another album other than the I'm Gay album?
Yeah, so, you know, and I appreciate that. You know, it's crazy. I'm Gay was actually a mixtape, so I never officially released. No problem. I haven't officially released an official album, man. Like, everything in my career has been mixtapes. That's why it's really exciting. Like, I'm definitely working on my official album. Like, I've been working on that for about 5 or 6 years. So, maybe even 7. So, what I'm doing right now is just focusing on getting some things together and focusing on some musical projects that I need to complete to get in gear for that. So, I'm thinking this year, 2017, some, you know, this year, 2017, like, I'm working. Hey.
I just want to know, where did you get your positivity from? Has it been there your whole life, or did you find it somewhere down the road?
Yeah, I think my core positivity has always been there. I think life kind of made me a little weird during my teenage years where I was finding myself. But my parents always instilled positivity in me and my mom, you know what I'm saying? Like, she always instilled that. And I was always a happy person, you know? I was always happy. I think life situations... were what made me kind of weird and learning how to like politics and surviving and politics in school and you know, the class systems that were even like in middle school and like elementary and high school, and like wanting to be a part of, you know, what was going on and sacrificing, like compromising my personality to like hang out with this group of people. And I learned a lot about myself, but I think the whole thing about it was I always remained a happy person. Anything that I did, it still was rooted from a positive place, even if, you know, it was something that doesn't reflect on my personality now. I always can look back and be like, well, at least I was happy, you know what I'm saying?
Do you mind talking about Whataburger?
Yeah, no, yeah, it's all good, man, it's all good. I appreciate it. Yeah, what's up with your question, man? We got to keep it going? Yeah. Yeah. What's up, bro? I see you, man. I appreciate that support, y'all, man. You know what I'm saying?
It's Bob.
Yeah, man. Love, man. I appreciate it, man. I appreciate it. Yeah.
What up, Lil B?
What's up, man?
I just got a quick question for you. It's a request.
Yeah.
So, we've all heard of the base God curse. Yeah. But I wanted to know if you give all of us here at the University of Florida, a base God blessing.
Oh, yes. 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 It gotta be, and I definitely will, and I'm gonna keep that in my mind and make sure that happens. So I definitely will do that. But you know, everybody in here is blessed. You know what I'm saying? Definitely. Love. Yeah.
12, thank you. Love you. My boys were back home. When I switched high schools, they included me. Thank you to your message.
Thank you.
So I was wondering if you could say I love you to them to this camera.
Yeah, man, no, definitely, man. I appreciate y'all. What's up, man? I love y'all, and thank you for getting everybody together, man. Lil B. All right. Thank you. Yeah.
I just want to ask a quick question about sticking on the theme of positive energy. For me, the 90s, like hip-hop and rap movement, had a lot more positive energy than it does today. I know, you know, Nas says hip-hop is dead and, you know, it's only rap now. But how do you feel about the current state of positivism and optimism in the rap game today?
Yeah, great question. I definitely think pre-Lil B, before Lil B really got in the rap game and started, it wasn't as open-minded, and it was more closed off. Now, just think about rap and hip-hop and music in general after Lil B has come in. Like, it's definitely different, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's a whole different ballgame right now, you know what I'm saying? And with the positivity, I think there is a lot more positivity in rap music because it's just, we see that it's an open lane. Like, I think anybody, if you are studying music and you like the artists that you like, I think people are really able to become successful in this day and age. Like it's a whole nother, you know, it's a whole nother game where people are looking for new. So music is extremely like, it makes sense like right now. Like the more people in music, because think about it, like if we all did music in here, which a lot of people do, you know what I'm saying? But think about if you all did music, like, that's more concerts, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's more places that, like, it's more money in the business, you know what I'm saying? So, like, people are dying for new music, and they're dying for the new artists, so, yeah, it's popping right now.
Okay, so the first thing I'll say, thank you, Basedworld, for being here with us on this beautiful evening.
Yeah, thank you.
So my question is, when I first discovered Lil B, I was like 15 years old and I saw a Wonton Soup video on YouTube, and I didn't like it at all. I was like, I don't like this man. This is too weird. It's too crazy. He's rapping in some kind of way I never heard before. And then a little bit later, you dropped that White Flame, Okay, all right. I'm with Lil B now.
Right.
Before, I have like a closed mind to it. So what do you say to those, as someone who's been on both sides of the coin here,
right.
to those who try to say that what you do isn't real hip-hop just because it's not like conventional?
Yeah, I understand being both sides, you know, being on both sides of the fence. You know, me, I definitely can, you know, be in confidence and just be like, well, you know, people will come to the party either late, on time, or they'll be in the party before everybody else is, you know? And a lot of people that really do love Lil B and understand it, they get it. I was late to the party on some other artists myself, you know? But I think for the main part is that, you know, that's my job as an artist, and that's what makes music fun for me to continue to keep making music that I know will reach people and reach those people, you know what I'm saying? Like, I definitely got time, so, you know, I understand what it means, and I understand to be closed-minded. I really used to be that way, too.
Thank you, Basedworld.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah. Hi, Lil B.
Hey.
I think that you're very intelligent, and I think that your words carry a lot of weight. So I would like to know who you're voting for in the 2016 election.
Thank you. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? I appreciate that comment too. Yeah, you know, it's crazy because I was talking to somebody and he was like, damn, you know, this new generation is like voting off who they vibe and chill with, or like who they think is chill, you know what I'm saying? Or like who they rock with. And, you know, I'm gonna keep it real, I'm Bernie Sanders, you know what I'm saying? I rock with Bernie, you know what I'm saying? Like, I rock with Bernie, you know what I mean? We got a good team behind him too, man. They connected to the streets, man. They reaching out, man. They talking, man. And Bernie is too, man. I rock with Bernie for that. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I definitely do.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah. You got about 2 more minutes.
Alright, hi Lil B.
Hey brother, how you doing?
Started listening to you in high school, and you were such a big part of my high school experience. Me and my friends all listened to you. You know, you were just a great time, and you were able to span your musical range. You know, you had bangers, and you were able to come out with serious tracks. It was really something to listen to, and I've been waiting so long to say, Task Force, Protect Lil B at all times.
Hey,
what I wanted to ask you real quick is, you almost started the internet rap, you know, thing. You started the movement. You have been able to last so long in a period when everything is a flash in the pan. You know, you have artists like Earl Sweatshirt shouting you out all the time, mentioning how everything that rappers are doing now you did 6-7 years ago. And I just wanted to know, like, what do you think is the biggest contributing factor to you being able to last so long in the internet age?
Just think being authentic and me actually loving music. I love music, and thank you for that question and the support. I just love music. I love music. I support artists of all kinds. You know, and I just love, you know, I mean, it spans, you know, from real street rap to Air France and Anthony and Johnson, you know what I'm saying? Like, it goes, like, real music has no, it's all love, you know what I'm saying? So, I understand from an artist, like, I get it, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, man, woman, anybody, like, if they on that paper and they're writing and they're making an attempt, I get it. You know what I mean? I get it. So, I get it.
Thank you, Big Scott.
Thank you.
First off, I just want to say thank you, Lil B. I love you. I love your music. I love your brand.
Thank you.
My question is more related to the marketing and the brand behind Lil B and Big Scott. It's something that people have just rallied behind. People love you. And I just want to ask, how do you think you've been able to differentiate yourself You know, people like Kanye, Kendrick, J. Cole, they have a very different marketing technique. They're more, you know, they're very different. So what was your source of inspiration when it came to your branding and your marketing as Lil B the Bass God?
And thank you for that question. I just have a really unique approach to marketing and branding in general. And treating every person with love, anybody that loves you, you know, like, it's just so exciting. I mean, if you got 2 views, that's a big thing. If you got 30 followers, that's huge. I mean, you're just making sure that you continue to support the people that support you and, you know, show love and continue to, you know what I mean? Just really do that. So I think that was my main thing. Paying attention, though, like, the marketing was just a huge thing for me. Marketing and branding, that's something I think bringing in a, you know, that deserves just a whole thing to talk about. You know what I'm saying? So that's huge, though. But
thank you.
Yeah, thank you. And I got one request and see if anybody wants to do it. I wanted to see if y'all wanted to be on my Snap. You know what I mean? Yeah. So if y'all can say, I love you, Lil B, thank you, Bass God, that'll be cool. if you want to, you know what I'm saying? But hey, so I guess on 3, we'll do it. So 1, 2, 3. Take this selfie, man, and we gonna get up out of here. Take these pictures. I think this is rare right here. Okay, you know, I love y'all, and I appreciate it, man.
before we leave, remember that you have to get accounts, you look out for each other. Take a minute to think through your safe way home. Will you snap? Will you ride the bus or use Uber, or will you walk in a group? Talk to the people around you and make sure that the Gator has a plan to get home safe tonight. And remember, an emergency dial 911, go Gators, and thank you guys.
We didn't know he was gonna. We didn't know he was gonna do that.
Yeah, we had no idea.
Shirt with the fucking arm, he's like, I'm just yelling at someone, so I'm just doing it. So, no, I can't.